Throughout time, there have been intersecting moments when the cycles of the great cosmic clocks line up in such a way that we're not only given a glimpse of all that is possible, but we actually have the opportunity to step beyond all that we have known as truth and participate in a grander truth within a higher level of consciousness.
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 Out of this vibrant nothingness emerged matter, energy, space, time, consciousness.
Consciousness.
Starting to realize that they're all connected.
I was no longer a fragment of the universe. I was the universe.
As 6.2 plus billion people of the Earth witness unprecedented changes in their world.
It's more and more obvious to people that there's a shift going on, a planetary shift.
We are the generation of hope. We are the generation of hope. Another me, another dream.
You cannot escape the responsibility of tomorrow by evading it today.
Quantum physics reveals that it's the invisible stimuli that are much more important. There's a simple quote by Albert Einstein that makes sense out of this, and the quote is, "The field is the sole governing agency of the particle." What Einstein meant by this very simply is the field, the invisible energy forces around us. They are the sole governing agencies of the particle, the particles matter. And so quantum physics says the character of matter is ultimately determined by the field.
If we were ever going to interact with our bodies, if we want to heal our bodies, we want to create peace in our families or our communities, we must speak to the fields that connect all things. We must find a meaningful language, a non-verbal language that communicates with the stuff that this world is made of. The bottom line, the through line, is that they're all speaking about an experience. An inner experience that we have focused on our hearts. What the science now is showing is that those experiences extend beyond our bodies into the world around us, because the field of our heart is part of the world around us and connected with that field. So that when individuals can find a way to create coherence in their lives and become more cooperative, less aggressive, more willing to solve problems together, that experience is transmitted in this field, and others begin to find the same experience just because they're in that field. They're in that field.
This chart shows a dotted line going up and down, which is the rise and fall on a daily basis of the number of people who are meditating as a group in Jerusalem. It's all on a volunteer basis. And the solid line represents progress towards peace in the war in neighboring Lebanon. And even before the benefit of statistical analysis, you can almost see from the raw data that progress towards peace, measured by reduced war deaths, reduced war injury, progress towards negotiated settlement among the rival factions, that progress towards peace goes up and down almost in lockstep with the number of people who are meditating as a group, radiating this influence of inner peace to become outer peace. When this was subject to mathematical analysis, the likelihood that this is simply due to some fluke, due to chance, is less than one part in 10,000, which for a social scientific experiment is extraordinary. To be able to say something with this certainty that group meditation prevented war, that is a really remarkable finding. The likelihood that this reduction of war was, again, simply due to chance and not due to the meditating groups was less than one part in 10 million, million, million. There is far more evidence that group meditation can turn off war like a light switch than there is evidence that aspirin reduces headache pain. Aspirin reduces headache pain.
Could help us here at Occupy Wall.
No problem can be solved at the level of consciousness at which the problem was created.
Put your hand on your heart.
Put your hand on your heart.
And just ask yourself internally.
And just ask yourself internally.
What kind of world do I want to live in? I want to live in. I want to live in. And now ask yourself. How can I make that happen?
How can I make that happen?
A question tonight, can you actually measure the emotional outpouring in a worldwide crisis?
Sometimes scientists think that they have done just that. Their machines and computers found a bizarre pattern right after several global disasters.
CBS News' Brendan Keefe explains this phenomenon.
September 11th deeply affected people far beyond New York and Washington. The attack sent shockwaves around the world, a global reaction that triggered a spike in a network of scientific instruments, just like a seismograph during an earthquake.
Each of those showed a similar pattern of change during that day.
Retired Princeton scientist Dr. Roger Nelson believes the emotional focus of millions of people on a single event like 9/11 may form a global consciousness.
When we have a feeling in our hearts, we're creating electrical and magnetic waves inside of our bodies that extend beyond our bodies into the world around us. And what's so interesting is the research shows that those waves extend not just 1 meter or 2 meters, many, many kilometers beyond where our heart physically resides.
The hour is late. It's time to decide.
Interdependence of all humankind, that we are human only through the humanity of other human beings.
Time evolves and comes to a place where it renews again. There is first a purification time. Then there's renewal time. We are getting very close to this time now.
What we need is not division, but is love and wisdom and compassion toward one another.
As we end this great fifth world age and find ourselves now at the beginning of the sixth world age of humankind.
A choice right now between fear and love.
And speak about the essential goodness of all human beings. We've been through rough times. The bad, the evil, doesn't have the last word. It's ultimately the goodness and laughter and joy and caring and compassion. Those are what are going to prevail in the end.
Thank you.
United. This one. This one. This one. This one. This one.